It's so great to have somebody that can just pick up and, you know, when I mess up, they can just do that. So thank you. Thanks for that. Today, the talk title is, We Got This, right? We Got This. And I came up with this because I was kind of trying to figure out this whole service and, you know, usually I just do my part, you know, I'm not flowing with the rest of the service. Judy does a big part of it. And so I'm, you know, trying to, you know, figure this out. And I'm saying to, somebody, you know, and I'm going, and they go, you got this, you know, and I'm going, yeah, you got this. And then I go, you got this. You don't got this. You don't got this. And my, this is the week I was going to actually take off. I just ended up having a family reunion at my house. I've got tons of people all over the house now. And so I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to talk about, you know, trying to figure out the service. Stacy, we've been working on it and stuff. And so I'm going, okay, I got this. And then it came to me and I sat down and I got quiet for a minute. And I said, no, you don't got this. Guess what? We got this, right? We got this. This is what we do. We put a lot of pressure right here saying, I got to do this. I got this. But the truth is, we got this. And even stronger than that is, we got this. Now, you guys are wondering what I'm talking about, probably. But I think some of you understand, when I'm saying we, it's not just about the we here, but it's about something bigger inside of us. When we're quiet enough, what we just talked about in that meditation, when we're connected to that, we got it, right? We got it. And we can do anything. We can really do it if we're connected to that something bigger. So, you know, and I'm thinking to myself, this is, you know, before I sat down for a minute, see, this is my problem. This is what happened with the, by the way, with the, my leg. It looks like this is my new friend, Betty Grace, I call her. it's like crazy. I ran up the stairs, cracked my kneecap, and, you know, right at this time, when my family's all here, right at the time when Judy's gone, this happens. And I'm going, you know, this is life, right? This is what I'm talking about. You know, it's part of that fertilizer that we're talking about in life. And so, you know, I'm kind of going in a million different directions. I'm like, wow, this is a good reminder. I got to sit now. I got to sit for a little while and think. So as I sat and thought, I started to think, you know, I don't have anything. We got something. You know, we have life running through us if we're connected to it. So here's what I know is it takes strength and courage and boldness to move through what needs to be done in our life. We have to have that. And we have to build our spiritual strength before we really need it. Doesn't that make sense? You know, sometimes I think that, you know, when things happen, we're going, wow, you know, what am I supposed to do now? But if you have built your spiritual strength, if you have reached down deep, your resilience is a lot better than if you wouldn't have. So that's what I'm saying. If you're doing good right now, keep coming, keep reading, keep praying. You know, keep doing what you're doing because we all need it. We all go through ups and downs, and we need that resistance, you know, or that resilience. You know, and I'm trying to think for all of us. God, I know your stories, and I know that all of you have stuff going on. You know, we all got stuff going on. And the truth is that we have to dig deep to find that bold in us. And we need that bold, that courage, that place where life is more peaceful, where life is happier, where there's I don't even like the word happier, because I'm not sure that's the word. It's more peaceful. There's a well-being. There's a sense of well-being. You know, so we look at our life. What is it? Is it a scary diagnosis that's going on for somebody? Is it a financial hardship? Is it the relationship issues? You know, and sometimes it's all of them in one time. One time that's happened to me before. You know, and it's pretty scary. And that's when we have to say, wow, you know, I got to dig. I got to dig deep to go for this. See? So what is it? That's what I want to talk about today. What is it that makes us say, we got this? That makes us know that we have this resilient spirit, that we're going to feel it, you know, and we're going to know, oh man, this sucks, you know, it's hard, but we're going to get through it, and we're going to be happy again, because a lot of people don't get there. They don't know they're going to be happy again. They don't know they're going to be okay. And I'm here to tell you that you are going to be okay. I promise you. But you got to do the work. You got to dig deep. You got to do the work to it. So researchers have really looked at the people that are resilient in life, and this is what they came up with. That most people that bounce back when stuff happens are resourceful and they have problem-solving skills. So think about yourself here. Number two, they seek help. You know, you can't do it alone. They seek help. Number three, they feel that they can do something that will help them cope. You know, what are you going to do? You know, how am I going to cope with this right now? And they have connections and social support. That's why I'm so grateful for you guys today. You know, it would have been hard to come here and see three people. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, it's wonderful. And it makes me feel, you know, so touched. So thank you. Anyway, these were the important things. But there was something else that Brene Brown, when she did this research, she said there was something else that stood out in people that had this spiritual resistance. Or I keep saying resistance. But it's resilience. They have this, I got this stuff. They can bounce back, okay? And this is a spirituality. And she said, the spirituality isn't a God up there that's gonna, you know, yay or nay, you know? It's not that. It's not a judge God that's gonna, you know, punish us or love us. But it's the power of God within us, reaching that place. That's what it is. She says that. I love this. She says it's a spirituality that recognizes and celebrates that we are connected to each other by a power greater than all of us. And that connection to that power is grounded in compassion and love. I think I wrote that on your thing, and you can read it. I know the font was pretty little on there. But if you can read that, it's so beautiful. Recognizing and celebrating that we're connected to each other by a power. Wow. That is greater than all of us. You know, we're talking about God power here, guys. Not talking about a human power. I'm talking about a divine power that is connected to each and every one of us, that holds us together, that is grounded in love and compassion. That is powerful. And if we get that, and that we live that, we can get through anything if we remember it. But every day, we have to remind ourselves. We have to pray up. That's what Judy says. I got to pray up today. And I know she's doing a lot of praying up, and that's how she's going to get through this. You know, and all of us, we gotta be in that connection with that energy of the divine being that is within us. It's always within us. It's not out there. It's not out there. That energy informs our human life, right? It informs our human journey. So when I am connected, I'm really connected. I can get things done. I'm more intelligent. You know, but that does happen. It does happen, okay? And it's when I'm connected, I'm more loving. I'm smarter. You know, it's like I do life better. My sense of well-being is better. My family likes me better, right, Jenny? They like me better when I'm connected, right, Stacey? Yeah. They do. They don't specifically really like me when I'm not. You know what I'm saying? We're different people. We're different people, but when we're connected to that love and compassion, wow, it makes all the difference in the world. So the more that we're there, the more that we focus on that incredible power within us, the better life is for us, the more well-being that we have, you know? And the truth is when we are connected to this being and we are in compassion and love, it gives us purpose, you know? It gives us the purpose of life. It's like we get up and that's our purpose, to connect. I'm going to connect with everything today. I'm going to get up in the morning, I'm going to have my coffee, I'm going to go outside, I'm going to see the gorgeous trees out there. Even the rain was so beautiful this morning. I got to get connected if I want to go on with my day. And I tell you guys, you got to get connected early in the morning so that you carry it through your day. That's how you do it. You got to carry it through your day, because it's pretty easy to walk out the door and go, whoa, it's raining, it sucks. You know, you're going to hit negativity in the world. You're going to hit a lot of it. So pray up. You know, find that love, that energy. And I swear to God, it's a warm, loving energy that flows through you. It's flowing in this room right now. We just can't see it. But it's here. You feel it when you're holding your baby, Jamie. Oh, my gosh. Right? There's a whole different feeling when you are holding that precious baby. That's the feeling of love. And just because we're not holding a baby, you know, we're holding the feeling. It's just coming out in the form of the baby. Right? Or when you're petting your dog. You know, it's the same thing. You get that warm, awesome, warm feeling. Well, just pretend it's there, right? And when you go out in the day, you know, it's huge. See, the truth is that our lives have perspective and meaning when we live like this. They really do. That's the foundation of all of this. Our life is purposeful, and it's meaningful. You know, and it's why we get up in the morning. You know, we always think we have some big grand purpose in the morning. But the truth is, our big grand purpose is to connect with who we really are. Otherwise, we're just this puppet of a human running around trying to get stuff done. I'm talking about myself here, running upstairs, cracking my knee, right? Maybe if I would have been centered and present, this wouldn't have happened. I don't know, you know. I mean, I'm not kicking at it. I'm happy. I'm not in pain, so I'm good. But that's what I'm saying is that when we're centered, life is better. So the whole foundation of this, see, actually springs from hope, and awareness. That's what it gives rise to. So people, you know, you say, what is hope? You know, and everybody thinks hope is just like this energy of, oh, I wish this would happen. That's not what hope is, you guys. Hope and awareness spring from what I'm talking about. There was a researcher at the University of Kansas, and he talked about hope. And he says, this is interesting, because I never thought about hope this way. When somebody says, I hope something, it's like, you know, it's not really going to happen, but I hope it, just hope it does, you know. So here's what he says. Hope is a way of thinking. It's a cognitive process. It is a thought process that is made of goals, pathways, and agency, you know. So he says that hope happens when we have the ability to set intentions and goals, right? So it's not just like we're hoping, I hope my leg gets better, but I, you know, that's not true. I have to do something about it, right? I have to wear a brace. I have to be careful now. So I can't just have hope and then, you know, think I'm gonna lose weight and eat Cheetos. Do you understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You have to like do your part. And then hope does its part. So that's, to me, that's what hope's about, and I love that. See? And he says that we are able to figure out how to achieve them and stay flexible if we believe this. We are able to stay flexible, you know, if we really believe that these intentions work. So, I mean, intentions are huge. They're huge in your life. They have energy. And your intention, see, comes from your head, your ego. I have the intention I'm going to hike and go up those, you know, mountains and stuff, you know, and I can prove to the world I can do this. That's my ego. Or I can get centered and just say, you know, thank you, God, you know, and be centered in this incredible energy, and my leg will heal the same way. Do you understand what I'm saying? That it's a deeper feeling. It's a whole deeper feeling. So, see, hope is a combination of setting goals and having the tenacity and the perseverance to pursue them and believing in your own abilities. So that's kind of what we're talking about today, is being able to believe, you know, believe in yourself too, and have that tenacity to move forward and know that you're going to get through it. Hope is learned. It's learned. It's not something that is just given to some people. You have to learn it. You know, hopeful people value perseverance and hard work. And the second one, that was hope, was the first one. And the second one of the foundation that I'm talking about is critical awareness. Tell yourself the truth of what's going on. And don't numb yourself. You know, don't numb yourself. And boy, that's a big one for a lot of people. You know, they can't face what's going on in their life. And so they either numb themselves with food, with alcohol, with chocolates. I know a lot of chocolate people here. And, you know, TV, you know, whatever we do. We numb ourselves so that we don't have to think about what's going on. And when you have something going on, you got to be clear. You have to be able to deal with it. So you can drop to that space and let that God self deal with it. You know, it's so easy to numb yourself. And to tell you the truth, man, you know, when you numb your dark part, when you numb the darkness, you're numbing the light too, right? And you'll never find that incredible energy that I was talking about, that God energy. You're going to numb that too. That's important to know. So instead of leaning into the discomfort and feeling what's going on, feeling it and moving through it, you're numbing it. So if you got something in your life that's happening, it is important that you deal with it. It's important that you cry through it and grieve through it. It's important that you, you know, are mad about it, you know. I mean, through kind of an irritation. Why did this have to happen now? You know? And it's like, okay, you know, that was my reaction, and that's okay. But am I going to camp out there? Are we going to camp out in all the negative stuff that goes on in life and that happens to us? I hope not. I hope we don't, you know? So leaning in requires spirit, right? When you lean into what happens, it hurts. And when it hurts, that's when spirit is available to you. That's when you get quiet. That's when you drop from your head to your heart and you sit by yourself for a while. The value of silence is so important. The value of silence is so important. When we can be quiet for a little bit, we're going to get to that feeling that I was talking about, that beautiful, palpable feeling of God. See, God is real. God is real. I think people kind of sometimes don't really get that the energy of God is right here. It's real. I mean, it's huge. So we need the attitude of, I can do it. It sounds really shallow, but the truth is that you kind of need that attitude in life that you got. You can get through this. You can get through this. In 1957, Dr. Robert Merton introduced an idea known as the Galatea effect. Anybody know what the Galatea effect is? Okay, it suggests that we tend to do what we expect we'll do. That's all there is to it. We tend to do what we expect we'll do. So that tells me if you don't expect to do something, you won't do it. Right? It's up to you. It's up to each and every one of us to decide that, you know. If you think that, you know, you can do something, you probably will do it. I mean, it's not too far out there. If you really believe you can do it, you know, then you can. But it works the other way around too. If you don't believe that you are capable of doing something, if you don't think you're good enough to do this, then you might not be able to do it. So the truth is, the Galatea effect says, yeah, I'm going to do this. And then it's like the universe sets it up. It sets it up for you so that you can do it. And I love this group because you guys are so, you know, I don't even like positive, you're positive, but you are grateful. You're grateful thinkers. And grateful thinkers are upbeat thinkers. And what they do is that they reach down to that spiritual resilience and they say, yes, I can. Yes, I can do this. And I'm going to get support. I can't do it alone, but I'm going to go forward and I'm going to do it. I'm going to get through this thing that is happening to me right now, and I'm going to be the better because of it. And that's what that's the truth. It's like that dumb stuff, right? It's like we take that fertilizer and we become better than ever before. Better than we ever have been in our life. Because I swear to God, everything that happens to you, you know, every bad thing, if you move through it, you become stronger and you become better and you become more compassionate and you become. I love that. You become. So the truth is that we have to look at our lives and look at our abilities and see where we can dig deeper, where we can, you know, find that trust. See, we never know, I'll tell you, we don't know what's coming next, do we? You know, I can't believe this has happened with you. Yeah, but what, are you kidding me? How can this happen, you know? But here's what I know is, no matter what happens, you know, we are able to move through it. We're able to move through the stress in our life, and we're able maybe not to choose what happens, but boy, we can choose how we deal with what happens, right? We can choose with how we deal with. We can choose the kind of people that we become through the tragedies in our life, through the stuff in our life, you know? If we don't get in the way, that's the deal. If we ourselves don't get in the way, you know, sometimes we're the obstacle. There's a quote that says, there are plenty of obstacles in your path. Don't allow yourself to become one of them. And the truth is, boy, sometimes we are our own worst enemy. Isn't that the truth? Boy, I know it's true in my life. You know, we have the ability to build our resilience, you guys. We have that. Sometimes we don't feel it. You're not going to feel it when you just have suffered a great loss. But you have that ability. And over the course of your life, you're going to have a lot of stuff happen. Well, you have. You're all old. I'm kidding, okay? We're all older, right? We're older. We've had a lot of stuff happen to us, right? And through the stuff in our life, we have built our resilience up, right? We have. You know, more than some of the young kids, right? Although I have to tell you, my kids are pretty resilient. They've had some stuff happen to them, too. Jamie, you too, you know? So that it, maybe age doesn't have anything to do with it. Here's what I know is that new research into resilience has found that our brain's innate neuroplasticity enables us to develop our own unique barrier of psychological Teflon, right? You have psychological Teflon right now, and your neurons in your brain are building that if you let them, right? That you have to do the work. Just what I said, you got to do the work, but you can build your own psychological Teflon so that you can get through the hurdles in your life and all the hardships You know? And when we do that, man, we bounce back from our setbacks. We handle change. We handle stress so much better. You know? Resilience is therefore not some trait that is lucky for some people. It's for all of us. It's just that we gotta work on it. We gotta work on it day by day by day. Hey, you're never too old. You're never too weak. You're never too wimpy to do any of this work, you know, because it's right there inside of you. It's all right there inside of you. We're genetically endowed with God, okay? We have God within us. And, you know, when I say that, don't run away, because every time, when I say, God, that they're talking about some God out there, that's not what it is. And everybody, you guys know that. You know that energy of God. So, PMP, purpose, meaning, and perspective. Get that in your life, you guys. Get that in your life. Actually, see it in your life. You have it in your life. I see it in your life. See it in your own life, and you will be resilient. Right? You're going to be resilient. You got this. We got this. Say it with me. We got this.
We got this.
All right, we got this. Okay. Life is beautiful, man. I'll tell you, it really is. It can be tough, but life is magnificent. So, as we close, please say with me, peace in my heart.
Peace in my heart.
Peace in my family.